Hi, this is Raj, CEO from Raj Hospitality Management. Welcome to the fourth episode of HI, Hospitality Influencer. Today, my guest is one of my best friend from Delhi. Of course, Mr. Vishwas Makhija. Everyone knows him from in the industry. He's there in the industry from the last 30-35 years. Who is the managing director for two organizations, the travel tour companies. One is India Inside Tours and also the Luxury India Holidays brand. A great guy, a fabulous person in the sense because you can always see him positive. I have not seen him, his face in a shrink, I've always seen him smiling. So, I get a lot of inspiration from him when he talks. He's very positive, great chef, and a great friend too. So, today, Vishwas ji will be definitely talking to you very positive about the industry and how this is going to, take place, how this is going to actually grow better in the coming days. All of us are still in the COVID, the issues and COVID problems, and we still keep talking about, but our concern or maybe our responsibility as a hospitality influencer, our responsibility as a HI is to see that we find the positive energies and we find the positive people who are responsible for the future or who are responsible for the growth of the industry. Hotel industry will definitely not wash out. Hospitality industry is going to grow and going to grow 10 times more. And that's what my confidence is. So enjoy watching Vishwas ji, who's going to give you insight about the hospitality industry.
Hi, hello everyone. It's a pleasure talking to you today. My name is Vishwas Makhija. I run a company called Luxury India Holidays and India Inside Tours, and I'm based in Gurgaon. It's a very interesting tourism subject, and apparently you're all studying to be future leaders, choosing careers, and I think it is a difficult period now for everyone. However, I'm going to step back and take you through my journey a little bit so that hope it inspires you because there is no shortcut in life. I started working at the age of 17 when I just finished my high school here in Gurgaon. Somehow I knew somebody in our family who was running an adventure travel company, and I was sent off to the mountains, to the Indian part of the Himalayas. I started as a camp boy in the trekking groups. Putting tents, carrying clients' bags, cleaning dishes. So I did that for almost 8 years. I trekked and walked across the Himalayas, doing a lot of trekking, a lot of expeditions, a lot of trans-Himalayan safaris. It was a lot of hard work. It was a lot of long drives. It was going on difficult roads, which I could never imagine. I mean, if those days my parents knew that I was going to such kind of places, they would never allow me to go. So I would work six months in the mountains, 6 months at the office during the winters, and I kept going on it. After a good 9 years of working and understanding the adventure travel part of business, I decided to take the plunge, as I call it, leap of faith. Like all of you, I come from a middle class roots, very average middle class roots, where me along with two sisters of mine, we grew up in a two bedroom house, rented, and our parents gave us great education. They both worked to make ends meet, but ensured that we had a good education. On the other hand, they also let us lose, so we could choose our direction and not force us to follow any careers, because those days in the 80s it used to be either parents would ask you to go to become a doctor, engineer, join the NDA, or join a government service, so it was difficult, but here I was on my path of making a career in tourism. So in 1996, I think after working for almost 9 years, I decided to jump the gun, as I call it, in a different way. I started my own company, called India Inside Tours. It was not easy decision to make. I was almost at a time of my career where I had a good job, I had a good salary at that time. But I think working for somebody was not my cup of tea, and I don't think I want to do that for the rest of my life. And with the years of experience behind me, I said, let me give it a try. I mean, if it doesn't work, I will go back and work again for somebody. So I took the plunge. And it's been very, very, very challenging ever since then. You know? This year we are into our 25th year of running our business, and it has been a super journey which has taken me all over the world, I have also made friends in every corner of the world. Companies who started to work with us in 1996 from Europe still work with us. Both the companies are primarily inbound tours, where we bring clients from Europe, North America, Latin America into the Indian subcontinent, covering India, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka for customized tours. And we do B2B, which means we do not work with direct clients. It is only through business partners. You know, so we have grown the company with international acceptance. I have a wonderful team here in Delhi. We almost employ about 25 people. And most of my team are basically taken from tourism colleges or IITMs around the country as their first jobs. And we nurture them, we train them, and we give them beautiful careers. I can honestly tell you, most of my staff are into their first jobs when they join us. And slowly they make their way up in the hierarchy. My immediate number two in the company has been working with us for almost 13 years now. She was just like you, finishing graduation or post-graduation in tourism. We went for campus interviews, gave them the opportunity, and here they are actually running the companies. Most of the time I'm not even there, but they take over. Of course, it's also about getting the right opportunity. We are in the present times, as you all know, in a very difficult wicket, which has come upon the entire world today, especially our industry, due to COVID-19. Tourism, I think, is one industry which is first to get affected when such things happen, and the last to start. And having said that, it is not the first time in the last 33 years that I have seen problems which have hit our industry. They have come. We have had flus, we had earthquakes, we had wars in the Middle East, we had 9/11 in the US, which affected global industries, and it affected us as well. Yes, COVID-19 is at a much bigger scale than we ever had, and it has not affected regions, it has affected the entire universe today, the entire world today. And I've been speaking to friends in Latin America, I've been speaking to friends in the US, in Europe, and everybody is on the same situation. So we are in no different, you know. But that's the way it is. But as human beings, as us, as industry, we are always very resilient. We always stick together. We always have a great understanding of doing things. And I'm sure as soon as things settle down, the industry will move forward. But in today's time, everybody is waiting for a vaccine so that people get even more confident to travel, and they will. So I don't see this prolonging for couple of years. It's a matter of couple of months, maybe extending into a year. After that, I think you're all going to be back in business, and I see that happening. And I would like to assure you guys that do not be disheartened. You know, do not worry about it. Yes, currently people have lost jobs, there is a vacuum, which obviously is created, you know, with the situation, but there will also be opportunities. There will also be more situations which will happen. There'll be more jobs which will come by. Now, what I would suggest is, as soon as you guys finish your college or you're looking for an option, just get the first job you get. Take whatever comes your way. Get into it. You know, even that means working in a hotel, in a restaurant, in a bar, in the housekeeping, in the front office. Slowly find your ground. You know, keep working hard. Stay focused on what you want to do. The biggest success anybody gets in any work you do, be tourism, be being an engineer, being anything, is staying focused. Because that is your core. If you are not focused, you do not tend to give justice to your work. I was always focused. I also had a lot of distractions, I must say, a lot by my friends those days when I was 17 years old. And the issue here is that with all these distractions, one thing interesting I will come back to, when I signed my first job, or kind of internship in a way, I decided to get a salary of 300 rupees. That was my kind of pocket money. You know? I would need more money from my father to even go to the office in Delhi when I was working in the winters, you know. But as I said a few minutes ago, I was determined, I was focused, I didn't lose track of what I wanted to do. So why I touched this point was, whenever opportunities come your way in the next couple of months, or some jobs come in your way, they may not be as good in terms of pay scales to begin with. Just take what you get, prove yourself, do your best. And when you prove yourself, you do your best, you give your efforts, trust me, somebody notices you. And the people who do not complain, who just stay focused on your work, are the ones who always go forward. So it's important, I think. And even more important in today's time, as the whole scenario has just changed completely, and it will keep changing. So you need to evolve with the changing times. You need to evolve in everything you do. And I think what is going to happen from here on is that inbound will come as it is, but I think the faster is what we have heard is the domestic market is going to come back slowly, which is a bigger, much bigger pool than the inbound tourism coming into our country. So I think with the new norms, with the new COVID protocols for hotels, for transporters, for guides, for everyone, the industry will revive. Because we Indians also love to travel. We love to travel with our families, with our kids. So as soon as we start traveling in the next couple of months, or by October or by fall, jobs will happen. People would want to have young people, young talents come and work for them, you know. I think my closing remarks here to everyone here would be that this is the time to reinvent yourself. This is the time to gather more momentum. As we always say, in a situation like this, there are even more opportunities. Yes, there are some obstacles, which I'm sure you guys will come over, you guys will go through, but stay focused. That's what I think I keep repeating all the time whenever I speak to youngsters like you, or I speak to people in my office who at times lose directions. You know, stay away from bad company. I don't mean to say bad company in that sense, bad company in terms of people giving you too many advices. You know? Yes, listen to people's advices, but in the end, do what your mind says you to do. Do not take a decision influenced by people around you or by others. You know, I never took a decision on anybody else's saying. In the end, I took a decision what made sense to me. Or even if it didn't make sense to me, to my parents at that time, but I followed my decision. And wherever I am today is because I always stayed focused on what I wanted to do. You know, so my parting words. Do not be disheartened, do not lose hope. There is so much going to happen in tourism and there is so much more coming for all of us. I'm not giving up and I think a lot of my colleagues in the industry are not giving up. We have a legacy, we have an industry which is one of the best in the world today in terms of hospitality, in terms of warmth we give, in terms of quality which we give in India, and the world recognizes the Indian love, the Indian care, the Indian affection, and we will overcome all this. So thank you guys, stay focused, stay happy and stay safe.